Coming up, Capcom gives us the finger. We are the amiibos, you never see us because we're small, very, very small. Chinese government, mobilise. PlayStation Fallout, Kojima doesn't like having shit thrown at him. And a fucking Minecraft movie. On to abusing news.
Ta-da! Right, Ramble on, episode 66.
67.
67? Is it 67?
Yep, we did 66 last week.
Stairway to Heaven.
Ooh!
It rhymes.
Ooh!
66 would have been biscuits.
Ooh!
Not as good. What's his hobnobs?
Check whether anybody's there and see whether chat's working. I'm El Padre and Hughes Doskin.
I'm going to stack absolute Jew.
He is one of them.
Abuse the news.
He's gonna do that.
In a minute. Mm. Doing something.
I'm just making sure chat works.
Chat work.
I bet nobody's watching.
Hold on, need to burp.
Classic.
Tastes like dumplings.
Dumplings? Tastes like dumplings.
Beef dumplings.
Beef. Yep, chat's working. Right, so.
Chat's working. Right, cool. Right. Resident Evil 7 demo. So.
Move over a bit.
Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
Came out at E3. And some people thinking it's like PT, because it sort of is, because it's not in the game. You can find shit and it says get out the house, but you can't get out the house because you always get fucking caught in somewhere.
Move over a bit.
And retreat. Yeah. We get caught somewhere. And we sort of like we had a talk about it, didn't we?
Yeah.
Because I googled it and I couldn't find any fucker that had got out of the place. And there were these extra items like a finger and a dummy finger, mannequin finger, yeah. And a fucking. An axe that you could find that was difficult to find, and they just couldn't figure out what to do. So I know, I mean, I just played it twice, it's two different ways of finishing it or not finishing it, and I know that people will be obsessing over it.
Yeah, yeah, well, we were talking about the PT thing, and our Hideo Kojima went, oh, it's going to take about 7 days in order to finish it, and within 5 hours, people sussed everything.
Yeah, they twatted
so
it.
So you were saying, you know.
Yeah, so I know people are trying to find this extra. Possible ending. Now they've put a picture up today for the ambassador, Resident Evil 7 ambassador program thing.
Yeah.
It must have been something you had to sign up to, I assume. But it basically shows a picture of the dummy's finger. It says we're up to 2 million downloads, something like that. And it says the path for now is closed, but patience.
Yeah.
And there's a picture of the finger. Which basically says, are they going to update it so that you can eventually finish it properly?
Just try and have a quick look for the picture now, I can't seem to find it at the moment. But
it's on the page.
Yeah, this is the page. That's the group. Well, that's what you were saying, weren't you? You were saying, have they artificially nerfed this game? You didn't use these exact words, but
yeah.
Have they artificially nerfed the game or demo? In order to make it so people couldn't just complete it. In which case, I think it's kind of shitty.
But, because they know that people are going to play the piss out of it,
yeah.
Because they did with PT and they figured it out. But there's a good chance it's impossible to figure out, because they need to update it first.
Yeah, because they would have gone, you can't interact with, you. This item will normally interact with this hole,
yeah.
But we haven't put the prompt in for you to press on
do
that
it.
Wall.
Yeah.
And that's just shit.
It's really fucking shit if that's the case, and I assume it is just because of that. The path for now is closed, basically saying you can't fucking do it, but be patient. And a picture of the fucking dummy's finger that everybody's trying to figure out what to do with.
Yeah, yeah. think we're on it. Maybe not. Let's have a look. No.
It should be right top.
At least not, no. There it is.
Oh.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, so let me have a...
See if I can get this up on screen for you.
There you go.
There you go.
That's exactly what it is. I can't... There we go. I've got a cursor on it. So there's the thing here. That's, like you say, it's... A little troll face type thing.
No, I put that on.
Did you? It's, I like that because that's how I felt when I read that. I'm like,
fuck!
Bollocks. I mean, right there, we said you called it there a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
Self-promoting here, but obviously that's...
I mean, luckily I'm like the sort of person who doesn't piss around too much with games. I'll finish them first and then if I can be bothered. But this is a little demo. So I know people will spend hours and hours and hours pissing around with that stuff. Hey, Chuck. they'll be tearing the fucking air out if they have.
Yeah.
And then they find out that was a waste of
the time. Well, I'd be really, really... I'd be pissed at it.
I'm pissed off and I didn't even do it. I still spent longer on it than I would have done. So I'm walking around with this fucking finger.
Hmm. Yeah, well, this is it. I mean, it takes away that... It, let's say it was ridiculously hard work to suss out where it is. And it's still doable.
Yeah.
And you were the guy that did that. That sense of achievement you would have got would have been fantastic. Would have been probably the same sense of achievement as the guy that found that final piece of in the X-ray of PT. You'd be like, fucking right, yeah, awesome. I want to share this with everybody. Mm. Whereas in now, no, I'm sorry.
Nothing. And they know full well that you're thinking about PT when you're playing it.
Yeah.
It's the same setup, pretty much. Pac-Man. Right. They've done single cell organism Pac-Man. So this scientist guy's from Norway, some university there.
This one?
He's put, yeah, that's it.
I'll just put that there.
He's put, this is under a microscope, and that Pac-Man type board.
I'll just try and make it bigger so people can see.
Is made, is a millimetre in diameter. So that's 1 millimetre.
Oh yeah.
And then there's these loads of fucking single cell organisms going around. Now, he didn't give too much information, but I assume one type eats the other naturally.
Yeah, possibly.
So one will be Pac-Man, and the rest will be the
like
ghost.
That bad boy there is after something.
Yeah.
Mind you, there's more of these little dudes. So that's probably the crazy skittish one or something.
So I don't know why they did that, but it's fun. I don't know how they did it, because they've built these little balls. I think they're...
Well, it's nanotechnology,
isn't it? Oh yeah, but so that's fucking sweet.
It's impressive. Yeah, I'll turn that off there again.
Macro Pac-Man.
Macro Pac-Man.
Making another Wreck-It Ralph 2.
Yeah.
9th of March 2018. This time it's going to be on about online gaming. I don't know what the...
So everything's going to be Call of Duty-fied.
They could do all kinds of MOBA. They could be MOBAs and Mario Kart. It could basically be the same movie, I suppose. But
I wasn't taken by Finding Dory, so I mean they're going to have to book their ideas up. I think that's a cash cow for them is the Finding Dory. So I mean, if did Wreck-It Ralph really do that well? Because I think I've seen it twice, and the second time was a little bit of a chore.
Yeah, first time I didn't mind it, but I never watched it again.
Yeah, second
don't
time
feel
I watched
the urge.
It. Yeah, it was a little bit of a
they
chore.
They said they want more Nintendo characters in there. But I don't know if they will now. Because they're going to make their own movies. Nintendo. Now they might be like, well, we did an experiment. We let Wreck-It Ralph have them.
Yeah.
And we let Pixels have a couple.
Yeah, Donkey Kong.
But now they're thinking, right, that works. They did well, even though the average movie.
Yeah, I don't think they had that many in Wreck-It Ralph, though, did they?
They had Bowser. And something else, I think.
I thought it was just Bowser in that. I mean, it's blatantly Mario Kart, though, what they were trying to do.
They had like a Mario Kart-looking area, didn't they?
Well, that was the entire thing at the end of the game.
Yeah.
The end of the movie, isn't it? That big race, that Mario Kart race that they had. But yeah,
I don't know, maybe Nintendo will let them have it, but if Nintendo were making their own movies, then they might just want to keep all that now. That was just their little tester. Like, you go on Wreck-It Ralph, you go on Pixels,
unless they publish it. I know it's Disney, like, it's Disney Pixar, isn't it? But they might publish it. You know, like, Sony got a lot of money from the Civil War film because Spider-Man was in it, because they still own the rights to Spider-Man.
Unless it's like you make the movie, we'll make the game.
Yeah.
Sort of deal.
Mm, possibly.
And then you can have some characters. So yeah. You want all the money from the game, you have all the money from the, you know, whatever.
Maybe, maybe.
Whatever they did, they could do that. Mm. I'll sort it out for you, Nintendo. Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Right, Battlefield 1, there was a closed alpha, and somebody's just, data miners have just dug into that, and they basically found everything out about it. How many levels it has, fucking this, what guns are in it, blah, blah, blah. They've left all that shit in there. Small. It's like a complete fuck up.
Right.
Silly.
Well,
silly.
Well, the thing is it, you know, it is, because that's the world we live in at the moment. Data miners are around there and they're going to do this kind of stuff.
They do it all. They've done it with Nintendo, they do it with everybody.
But, I mean,
just assume that they're going to dig into your game, and if it's there, they'll find it.
So where have you found all this information?
On the alpha. It's a closed alpha.
Right, on the actual, right, okay.
So they played that, somebody.
Hey, dude. I'm going to smoke because I'm coughing.
Yeah, they've done what they do. Data miners, they find everything.
They do, that's why the data miners, they mine for data.
They mine for data. That's what, you probably can't hide it though, on an alpha or something. It's like, it'd take so much effort to take all that shit out.
Well, yeah, it'll take
a separate build.
What they'd have to do is, they'd literally have to copy out all that code and then make sure that any other code that has got any kind of relevance to it is then gated off. So there's no point in them doing it.
Yeah, so...
I mean, what it is they should have... This is... I'm not a wife... With your wife beater on. Yes, I am. Check it out. Is now.
Being
don't
a
have
wife.
A wife, though. Don't have a wife. She left me. Oh.
Just beat other people's wives.
I just did that instead. It's easier.
Pick a wife.
It's easier because I can beat the wife and not have to put up with the conversation and awkwardness afterwards.
You don't have to make up.
No, I just leave that to somebody else.
It's your problem now.
It's your problem.
It's like babysitting.
Go away.
It's like babysitting. Just give it back. Right. Far forward PS4 and mods there. Just being delayed. I'm delayed.
Do you think that's down to the infrastructure of the PlayStation 4
that
everybody bangs on about being the better than everything?
I think they're just struggling with it.
Fanboy, don't
you? I think they're just struggling with it.
Well, they struggle.
Because is it closer to is the Xbox One closer to a PC than
the
PS4
is? It runs on DirectX whatever, and everything about it is
PC.
It's a PC, yeah.
So that's probably got a lot to do with how they
Well, Bethesda have always struggled putting the games onto PlayStation consoles. I mean, even PlayStation 3, Skyrim on PlayStation 3 was fucking terrible.
That's because they had that weird shit, they had their own shit though, didn't they, on PlayStation 3? I thought PS4 was more PC-like.
It is more PC-like, but they didn't want to pay Xbox, Microsoft, for all the other stuff, because you have to pay them anyway for any game that's developed under DirectX, because you have to buy DirectX. Should've stuck with Xbox. And we're getting by the PlayStation this time. Well, I mean, to be fair, if you got the Xbox One, you...
Get the S.
Yeah, get the S. In fact, yeah, get the S if you want that. But, I mean, they're as much of a muchness. They've both got major flaws. But you've got a PC, though, haven't you?
Yeah, you get all your Xbox games on there now. Well, soon enough.
So it's weird, that one. Bethesda always struggled. Even PS4 version of Fallout 4 apparently looks better than the Xbox One, but there's loads of other technical issues with it.
Little bits.
Yeah, it's an odd one.
Amiga. A new Amiga. An Amiga.
Your Amiga.
So we had the Spectrum thing, didn't we?
I'll bring that up now. I can't remember what that one was called.
There was a Spectrum week. You couldn't put your cassettes in, though.
Yeah.
But you could play all... There were 1,000 on it to begin with, weren't there?
We pissed around with it, didn't we? Play Xbox.
Yeah.
No, that's the Amiga right there, our Amiga 500.
Yeah.
I'll just put that there.
There's different versions of it. It seems to range from €169, whatever they are, and €119.
One thing I will say about Euros is they're not as powerful as they used to be.
Nothing is. is. So you can pick one of them, and it looks a little bit like one of them. I don't know how different the other ones are. I have no idea.
Can we have a gander?
Let's just click on it, yeah.
Let's have a click and find out. We'll do this shit live now. We'll mess around.
That's it. It looks pretty sweet. You can put your discs in.
You can actually put floppies in.
You can put the floppies in. That's what I like about
it. That's brilliant.
Yeah. So
custom floppy controller.
You can also save what's on them onto the controller or something.
Right.
So you just store them. So you don't have to keep putting the disc in.
All right. So the essentials become ROMs then, don't they?
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Okay. Brilliant.
So you can do that, and it's supposed to be pretty good. Better than the stuff you get off the internet. You know, downloading it that way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Emulators.
There's Johnny apparently. Alpha. Christ, I don't know his name. In comments right there. Alpha, here's
all right.
Johnny. Hi,
it's
Johnny.
Hey, dude.
You'll be
coming up wet. You always are.
So, that's actually quite
it's
cool.
It's a nice little thing for retro guys, isn't it?
It is, yeah. And it's got scan lines as well. Scanlines, 80%.
It's pretty high definition, this, that, and the other.
Yeah,
it's all this technical
yeah.
shit.
Well, the thing is a lot of
USBs, HDMI.
Retro gamers, they really like the scanlines because you've got a high definition TV, you don't get scanlines anymore. It's
right.
on CRTs.
It just makes it look better.
It
looks too nice when it's high definition because it actually looks as shit as it actually does. There's no blurriness to have.
It's more blurry. Exactly, yeah, it's more blurry
yeah,
on
I mean.
You, yeah, exactly, yeah, so if you scan lines, it reduces the blur, but then again, you are reducing the amount of stuff that you see.
But you don't want to see a lot, because that whole shit looks fucking gash when you put it on a big screen.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
Like, wow, I remember looking better than this.
So, that's that one.
Like your Amiga stuff, I know Pash does, because he's about to death. I can't remember if I already mentioned this, but, because it's an oldish one. But there's a trademark for the NX version of Zelda.
Ooh.
And under the section software, it says discs, as you'd expect.
Yeah, and...
And it says cartridges.
Yeah, you mentioned this a while ago.
And it says memory cards.
Yes.
I don't know if I mentioned it on one of the Rambles, but I did post it.
You did mention it on one of the Rambles. Didn't so much mention.
Well, I mentioned it a while back.
That was
a rumour, but this is on their trademark thing.
Right.
So unless it's a mistake, it says cartridges and memory cards.
I think what's probably happening there is.
But the Wii U version just says disc and download.
It might be a matter of we get all that as a trademark, which then covers our asses. But because we're the Wii U, they know exactly how they're going to be dealing with stuff.
Well, it just seems like an odd thing to put down, though.
I mean, cartridges means doesn't really mean. I mean, like memory card. Essentially, your 3DS games are on an SD card.
Well, they say cartridge. When you look at the SD ones, when they've done it the same with the
DS
games, it says cartridges. Mm. So unless someone's got mixed up, but the fact that it says memory cards as well, that's weird, and cartridges.
Well,
it's like a double whammy.
We don't know what the legal terminology is for certain things anymore. You know, they keep changing. Now, I'm hoping that there is some form of cartridge coming out on it. That'd be interesting. You know, some actual hard. But what might have happened is there might have been a differential between memory cards and cartridges because of the DS.
Yeah, that might be some sort of save data transfer thing.
Maybe,
just to go from, you say they do a new 3DS, or they do off somewhere, you can transfer it from there to there, but they actually use discs, maybe. I don't even fucking know. But that's interesting. Anyway, type stuff. I reckon, like you said, I think it might not be a cartridge, but it might be something that can transfer.
I think it's legalese. I think that's what it is. I think because of the 3DS are essentially SD cards, they'll call them cartridges, like you say. But they'll look at it and go, yeah, but it's only your memory card. Whereas in the cartridge itself is something, traditionally, it's something that has like capacitors on it and resistors and all this kind of shit.
Mm.
So maybe that is to cover what the new version of the card is, because it might be extremely proprietary.
It might be, yeah.
As opposed to...
It might be crossed between a cartridge, a disc and a fucking memory card.
This is it, because the 3DS games are actually an SD card, just with a case around it.
Yeah.
That's all they are. They are just an SD card. They just are big SD cards. So it might be a way of covering the proprietary
thing. It could be, right.
So it might be legalese, that. I think until it's been confirmed, but it still is very interesting.
Well, whatever it is, it's going to be fucking weird, it seems.
It's going to be weird. It's going to be a bit odd. And if you can pick that up, because it'll have battery memory on it, battery backup memory,
and transfer
on a cartridge, so it can go from my house to your house.
Or just bring it around.
Yeah, and then you can continue again, which is something that you struggle to do now, which is what PlayStation 4 and Xbox One try and do with the cloud. So
save
you shit to the cloud.
Yeah.
You're like, well, yeah, but then I have to go around to my mate's house, I have to download my profile.
It's got simple.
Whereas if it's just, that's where I am.
You want it quick, you don't want to piss around, you just want to go, here's my games, douche.
Yeah.
But you know they're mine because they're on my cartridge, so I haven't robbed them.
Mm.
I'm just lending them to you, like, you can't be anything. Mm. Watch Dogs 2! Shit, a dick, has no towers! So this is supposed to be the first Ubisoft game.
With no towers?
Since I can remember, with no towers. Zombie U didn't have towers.
Sort of did.
Did it?
It had its own versions. Those thingies, cameras.
Well, the cameras.
Yeah, you had to hack.
Sort of, yeah. Would show that, yeah, you're right, actually. Yeah.
So there was that. So, I mean, they all have their own little version of towers.
So apparently you can do what the fuck you want without pissing around with these towers. So were the towers in Watch Dogs 1?
Yeah, yeah. Well, they weren't specifically towers.
But so
they
were, thing.
They were towers. They were Wi-Fi hub things that you go on and you hack, and then that opens up
your missions. And
yeah, it's
where guns
exactly are. Like a tower in Assassin's Creed or those.
Well, the car racing game.
I was going to say the car racing game.
Okay, yeah. Madness.
Yeah, absolutely. Mental.
China.
We're going to hit you with China now.
China. Everybody worries whenever you say China. Right, China. The Chinese government. That's even more worrying. Right. They're checking every single mobile game. And they've been doing that since the 1st of July. You've got to give them something like 20 days notice to give them the game. Mm-hmm. And then they'll check it. And it's mainly story ones. They're obviously checking for any sort of propaganda or some shit that they don't want people to hear. I don't know. And then they'll allow it on whatever form, I assume. You're not allowed to change names in the game afterwards, so updates are going to be a problem.
Yeah.
Because they have to check that as well. I mean, you've seen how much shit comes out of a mobile.
Yeah.
Imagine that checking all that.
Nothing is coming out in China.
So it's just fucking pointless. Like, oh, wow.
That's...
What a world.
That's just... craziness.
Minecraft movie.
Minecraft. See, out of all the game movies, such as the Angry Birds film, which I'm going to have to watch. Oh, we have DDR Duck. DDR Duck X. Remember when you're at the bar and she wants to gurgin your flirgin? Say yes.
Yeah,
will do. When she wants to gurgin your jergin. Minecraft is alright.
Yes, okay. So Minecraft, the movie. There is a movie.
Click follow.
You already know about this movie.
Dance. No, I think this is a... This is actually a new one, yeah.
Right, Minecraft movie. There's been that many fucking movies. Tetris, all kinds of crazy shit.
Did you guys hear there's a Tetris movie coming out somehow?
Yeah.
I just mentioned it right there.
Yeah, we've done the Tetris a little bit, like.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, but...
It's a three-part sci-fi...
It's going to be like Ender's Game, but as opposed to flying around, it's...
It confirmed that...
Thank you very much.
Cheers, dude. It confirmed that the Tetris pieces won't have legs on them.
That's all right, then.
I speculate a space invasion of Tetris blocks. I don't know how it's going to work, though.
Yeah.
But there's a Minecraft movie. That could be anything, really. I've seen a little stories of Minecraft where they've got the people walking around.
Well, there is a bizarre narrative type thing to Minecraft anyway.
There is a story. Some like weird zombie shit happens at night.
And Slenderman or Enderman and spiders and Steve and all this shit. So there is... Oh, there we go. Alpha Chronicle. Thank you very much. You knew we'd dance, motherfuckers. Yeah. Cheers.
It's got a out on the piss dance too, by the
way. Yeah, it is. Yeah, this is how I get.
Exactly the
this
same.
This is how I get none of the ladies.
Yeah, so if you ever, if what is it that plays that? Like a little kazoo?
It's a kazoo, yeah.
A little kazoo. If you have one of them and you see us in a pub, just play it in her ear, that exact tune.
Or we just can't stop it. It's like physical Tourette's.
Yeah, it's dance Tourette's.
Dance Tourette's.
So yeah, Minecraft movie. 2019, so it's a while off. 24th of May, somehow they know exactly what day they want it to come
out. It's definitely coming out 24th of May.
2019. Do they get delays like games?
Some of them do, yeah. What often happens with movies though is they bring them out. Well, what they'll do is they'll make a film, and then if one of the actors in it has suddenly got a big role afterwards,
or they'll delay hold the movie still afterwards.
So, for instance, Chris Hemsworth, the guy who plays Thor. He did the remake of New Dawn. Is it New Dawn?
Red Dawn.
Red Dawn. He did the remake of Red Dawn. And the thing is, that was filmed 5 years. Or 3 years, actually. Before.
Was that a terrible movie that we watched?
Yeah, it was terrible. Yeah. It was terrible. Where Koreans invade America. The original film was in the 80s with Molly Ringwald and Patrick Swayze.
I think the man was.
The Wolverines! So that one's cheesy as fuck, but alright. Mm. Well, Chris Hemsworth did that film, and then in post-production, while they were editing and stuff like that, he ended up getting called up and started having talks with Marvel over doing Thor.
Right.
So the movie company went, right, well, Disney are going to chuck shit ton of money at that.
Yeah.
And they're going to really promote it.
Yeah.
And he's going to be household name. Regardless of how shit that film is, he's going to be household.
Yeah.
So they held this film back.
Bastards.
So that's what happens more often than actually...
It's
a strategic delay. Yeah. So then when they drop it out at cinemas, people go thinking it's going to be good. It's shit.
So if one of these Minecraft blocks becomes famous after the movie's supposed to be coming out in a big film, they will
I think they're pushing the luck though by bringing it out in 2019. That's 3 years away. Minecraft, as big as it is set to topple.
Yeah.
Fatigue is going to kick in soon because it's nearly 10 years, that game. By the time that comes out, I bet it's about 10 years.
Might do. How long did Warcraft last before they got bored of that?
Well, Warcraft lasted forever and ever and ever and ever and ever because there was no competitive, no solid competitive.
No.
And then what happened was the free-to-play game started coming out.
But there isn't with Minecraft, really.
That's when it started hitting. There is this fucking shit ton of versions of it.
Clones, like.
Yeah, they are clones.
But, I mean, Minecraft, so it's like Warcraft. There was loads of games like that, but... when did... what were we asking?
Warcraft, when did
that
get stale to the populace?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I suppose you're right there, actually. There isn't actually a...
There's lots of copies, but there's not lots of clones,
but nothing as tangible and strong.
Yeah.
So I don't know. But it will be about 10 years by the time that comes out, I think.
Maybe they'll need a boost by then. Because, like, Warcraft movies come out now, and Warcraft, compared to what it's worth, it isn't as big. It's still the biggest one, I think, but...
Yeah, I think there's 15 million people.
Yeah.
I mean, I think at the peak, there was 19 to 22 million people.
I don't know, whatever it were, it used to be stupid, and now it's like... Compared to their own success, it's shit, but it's still better than everybody else, the competition. Yeah. So maybe Minecraft will be like that. Maybe I'll need a boost at that point. A woman sued Microsoft for $10,000.
Oh, please tell me something very easy so I can sue them. I need some money.
It was a sneaky Windows 10 update, and she didn't fucking want it. And she runs a travel agency, and she didn't know what the fuck it were, and she couldn't use a computer for 3 days. Now, Microsoft said you can uninstall up to 30 days afterwards, and she's like, well, I don't know how I got it.
Yeah.
So I certainly don't know how to uninstall. I'm like, can I just go to work and do shit? Anyway, they just gave me $10,000 and said fuck off. So
I might try it.
I might try that. Okay, Xbox games with gold, and I'll do the PlayStation ones as well.
Pretty good this month for gold.
So you got Banner Saga
2.
2.
That's a brand new fucking game.
Which is a brand new game. And you love the first one.
Yeah. I've downloaded that one. I haven't had a chance to play it. I was going to play it yesterday. But I'm going to play it. I'm going to do a review. I need to get a review up of Halo 5. I'll do all this shit in closing. In fact, we'll talk about that in closing, actually.
We will.
Yeah, not looking forward to it in closing, though.
What's this? Tumblestone? Did you get a chance to check that out?
Tumblestone's out later on in the month. It's,
yeah, I just bought them as well.
Yeah, I've not.
That's
not,
the goal for this
not
month.
Seen that, yeah.
3, 6, so you
have to get this as well.
Yeah. 360, Vegas 2, Rainbow 6. Vegas 2, that was good, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good. Yeah, I own that fucking thing on the digital download, but it won't fucking recognise that because it came out with fucking Rainbow Six Siege, didn't it? So what it is somehow that's got a different fucking code behind it to stop me from using it.
Just made yours redundant.
So it's now, made mine redundant.
Yours is not backwards compatible.
Mine's not backwards
anymore.
Yeah, exactly. Mine, it's the same when with people, remember when Fallout 4 came out and you got Fallout 3? Those people who had that previously digital, downloaded it on the 360, that wasn't available to them, motherfuckers.
Fucking hell.
That wasn't available to them. No, because this is an exclusive. So it's like, look.
So it's giving me one, I'm taking with the other. So it's giving to these new people, and taking away from people that might not want it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then Bethesda turn around to the console owners and say, if you want to buy Skyrim, you're going to have to pay £40.
Yeah, that's bollocks.
You know what I mean? So it's like, you've been screwed over by. Well, just say you've been. You're not being screwed over, because.
We'll just wait till it's £20.
If
you're
looking at it this way, I mean, Microsoft do that. Backwards compatible thing, it is good. It's really good, actually. To be fair, so I mean, as much as it's sucking, I Rainbow Six, big Clancy fan. You Rainbow Six. I wasn't a massive fan of Siege. I liked the co-op bit of Siege, but I did not like the competitive bit of Siege.
I knew what you meant, Albert. I knew what you meant.
Is there a review on Shovel Games?
There is a review by some guy called Aaron Hughes. Who wears shoes, but not today. There is a review up there, but if you love Rainbow Six, but in fact, go and check it out. Showgames.co.uk and write this comment. You can comment at the bottom. People don't seem to do it anymore. Since I put a capture thing in there, so that people can't just fucking spam.
Right.
I don't get any more death threats.
Oh, right, thank you.
So that's why the website actually gets updated a bit more, and I don't feel depressed about the
website.
Right,
because every time you log in, so
every time I log in, you're always some fucking nasty comment. But yeah, just bots. So somebody invents a bot to go around the world
just being a dick,
being a twat with people.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Great, isn't
I mean,
it?
Hats off to the guy. I'd probably do that shit.
Yeah, but you murder them as well. That's the difference. Yeah. Right, PlayStation 4. PlayStation Plus, sorry. Fury.
I don't know what Fury is.
Don't know what that is at all. I don't know what the other one is though. Saints Row, Gat Out of Hell. Was that some DLC?
That's the DLC thing. It's meant to be alright.
I assume it's standalone because it just doesn't mention that you get Saints Row. Is it 5 that we're on there?
Four.
It doesn't mention that you get the Saints Row with it. It just says Saints Row, get out of hell. I don't know. Does anybody know this?
Right. Okay. This is what that looks like. This is Fury.
All right. Weird. Oh.
Strange.
I think that's supposed to be all right. You know.
Cell shaded type.
Yeah.
One ton ninja. Yeah. It's good be able to just pop stuff up on screen, isn't it?
Ta-da! PlayStation 3, Fat Princess, Call of Juarez. Bound in Blood. Is that the first one, or is that a sequel? Is it?
That's the newest one.
Newest one,
which is actually set in the Old West, because Call of Juarez, Devil's Cartel, I think. Was Devil's Cartel Call of Juarez?
Cartel rings a bell.
Yeah, something Cartel. It will be the standalone. I own Siege.
Standalone. The Get Out of Hell.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll be standalone, yeah.
Cool. Vita. Orishika. I don't know what this
is. Try and find out what Orishika is.
Orishika. Right. And so he's doing that Prince of Persia Revelation for the Vita. What that is either.
So Prince of Persia Revelation, that's Orisha.
Let's have a look at some of these pictures so I get a gist.
Oh, fucking wrong monitor. No. So, it's that tap again.
Alright.
JRPG.
Oh no.
Yeah, I won't touch that. I won't touch that.
I don't like them.
But people love them kind of things, so there you go.
For me. On the Vita. And that's that. The news.
It's been abused.
It's been abused. So.
1 second, bear away from me while I get myself prepped. Prepped and loaded. For you guys. I wish they did Zombies standalone.
Zombies.
Yeah. They should do. They should do it as a £5 download.
Yeah.
Online.
They should do that with all the bits.
It's like, we've got this side thing. You pay £5, you get this.
Should do that with a campaign. £5 download.
Yeah. Well, they should do that with Halo 5, which we'll get on to. Right, moving on to.
Can they even see you?
Yeah, they can still see me.
Can you? Oh.
Yeah, I've got a list in front of me. Coming up this week, July the 5th, which is tomorrow, we have Banner Saga 2 coming out on the PlayStation 4. Look forward to that being buggy. Fury, PlayStation 4, already mentioned this. Energy Hulk, PlayStation 4. Lost City.
We've got new games that are coming out now for these. Downloads, not these Xbox Gold and stuff.
Yeah, well, I think they've realised that giving somebody Gears of War 1 is actually semi-insulting.
Yeah,
so,
it is.
Weird. Where am I? Yeah, Lost Sea, PlayStation 4, still tomorrow, Rocket League Collector's Edition retail, Xbox One, PlayStation 4 and PC, so that's coming out on disc now. There's people in the Game Awards for 2016, group, if you go and check that shit out, that I've been voting for Rocket League in the independent game section for 2016 because it came out in 2016 for the Xbox One. Now, I argue that that is not an independent game anymore. But that's me.
Oh, okay, so it's really like back-by.
PlayStation threw a shit ton of money at them, released it on the PlayStation first. Then Sony gave then Microsoft gave them a fuck ton of money, and then they made a fuck ton of money. They're no longer, they're backed by big developers now.
Yeah.
They're no longer independent, but the Game Awards is for the people, so if you decide that that's an independent game, I guess it is. Okay, so still tomorrow, Romance of the Three Kingdoms, 13.
Wow,
that one, that princess is a slag. PS4 and PC. The Room 2, that's the second room for the PC. And then July the 7th, which I think would make it Thursday, Castle Storm for the Rift in Gear VR.
Oh, wow.
Cool, excellent. Well, I say excellent, I've got that on Xbox 360. It'll be alright in VR. Inside for the PC. The Lion Song Episode 1, Silence for the PC. Nurse Love Addiction. Nurse
Dating Love Sex
Addiction.
Game. What are we calling it?
PC. Trizeal Remix for the PC. And Friday we have Carmageddon Max Damage for the Xbox One and PlayStation 4. This is a retro, this is again cashing in on your retro feelings of games. Hawken, which is a mech warrior fighting game, which was an online battle game, which was an indie darling about 2 years ago. It looks really, really fucking good. That was an indie darling. That started off on Steam, it got kickstarted, and also then got greenlit. That's coming out on the Xbox One and PlayStation 4 on Friday. I did not hear about this. And that is my sexy little biscuits. That is the, is that?
That's fucking that. This is fucking this. Voice of the peoples. Hurricane. Oh, a bit acid.
No Hurricane this time, my friend.
Oh!
It's the people!
Who's this guy? That's gotta be you. Just raging. That is the Angry Mountain.
That's the Colossus.
Oh.
Colossus. And Akuma on his
take
own.
Take everybody on.
He's just on his own. He doesn't understand.
Who's the girl?
The girl is Sakura from Street Fighter.
No, I mean from the group.
Ah.
Who's this guy here? That's pointing his fist up.
He's from something. I think he's called Yuri. I think it's called Yuri.
It also like a Johnny Cage punch to the balls. He just did a split switch.
Oh, Johnny Cage win.
So voice of the peep.
Voice of the peoples, Ariam Preston. See if we can get this one up. Seems that Mario might be gay, I think.
Oh, buddy.
Books of Adam. I don't remember doing this. But there it is. Books of Adam. Apparently. Princess is in another castle.
Try and make it bigger for people to see with their eyeballs.
But Mario disagrees.
You are my princess.
Yeah. Should get one of them. Should get like a rainbow hat. The Ariane and
Natalie
have Mario and Luigi stuff on.
They were Mario and Luigi during the Mario and Luigi evening.
Retro Games Night.
Retro Games Night at the Batcave.
So if you get like a rainbow one of them.
Yeah.
That might like, actually look quite cool.
It would probably look pimping.
Pimp that. Graham Daly. How many of you have met lifelong friends through gaming?
No, it's the next one. Me. I met me through gaming. I didn't know myself until I had to rage quit from a game. I don't think anybody knows themselves until they've rage quit a game.
Yeah, that's when you find out it's not a woman that will stress you out. No. I mean, they will. They'll drive you insane. You will punch walls. But a game will make you smash your controller. And you wouldn't smash your controller for a woman.
No. And I did smash my controller. In fact, I didn't smash my controller, I smashed Michael's controller.
Yes. I'm talking about smash controllers.
WWF 2000.
Yeah.
On the N64.
Graham smashed yours as well.
Yeah, he did.
So, yeah, I don't know. Not really. Because I don't play online, I suppose.
You got that on video, though.
What's that?
Graham's smashing my controller.
Was it actually on video?
Yeah, it's on the Dead or Alive tournament video, which has no audio, unfortunately, because somebody decided to turn
my mic. But do you see him actually doing it?
Oh, you see him like, ah, boom, stand up. Unfortunately, there's no sound, and the sound was brilliant, because everybody cheered for him. Went,
yeah,
he went, smash, everyone. Quiet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shit. So, yeah, there's a few people on there. I think it might have been Tom O'Toole, but he was talking to someone on some gamer over there for ages, and we were getting along, but then he went to college and he made friends with a random guy, just so happened to be exactly the same person.
Wow.
That's fucking cool. Wow,
that is really good.
So yeah, there you go. Thank you. Lovely. Chris Broderick.
Broder.
Brothers.
Rick.
Oh, I didn't know about it. Does anybody on here know if you can carry over choices in Banner Saga. Well, simulate. I assume he's choose them if you haven't played the other version, like Mass Effect.
I'm not too sure. I haven't played number two yet, but I do know that if you have got it on the same platform that you had the original one,
it will carry
your save over. Yeah.
But we don't know if you can make the choices.
Graham
Daly, so he won the Mario Kart tournament, didn't he?
He did win the Mario Kart tournament. I mean, he was lucky in the end, because we had the final was four people, best of three races, and it ended up, well, go watch it, it's on YouTube.
You can check that out on YouTube.
But, it was very, very close at the end.
Show games YouTube. There'll be a link
somewhere. I wish I went to the Mario night, but was working. Oh, no! Kick my nose. Mario Knight. Just so we know, just to fill us in, Alpha Centauri Prime. I've forgotten your full name. Who are you from the group? I presume you're from the group. We like to know the human names, not just your alter egos.
Very confusing, isn't it?
It is.
So many names. So, I mean, did he win a prize?
He should have won a trophy, but it went missing, yeah.
He mentioned on here, he was saying, has anybody seen my trophy? Because it was like a cool trophy, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. It was the green shell cup thing.
That I think was sweet, yeah.
Mm, really nice.
So, that's gone. that's gone. Right, I didn't understand this. So this is Johnny Floyd. It's this picture here. Now, I just thought of Zelda straight away. But is this reference to something I'm not understanding in Skyrim?
This is Skyrim, yeah.
I know it's Skyrim.
If you eat that chicken, everything goes fucking batshit.
So it's like Zelda?
You don't get attacked by a fuck ton of chickens. It's just that's just the worst thing you ever do. Because
why?
Every fucker will kill you.
Because you've killed the chicken?
Everybody will go mental.
That's a nod to Zelda, though, isn't it?
It probably is
it
a lot
must
of it.
Be.
Yeah. Oh, I never got attacked. I mean, Ariane played Skyrim quite a bit. Possibly other people in the chat at the moment, but I did kill a chicken one time and nobody fucking forgot.
Right.
Nobody forgot. I went and attacked the king.
Shit. Because I always kill animals.
There were a point in the game where I went to the fucking king and I'm talking to the king, the ultimate enemy in the game, the person you're meant to try and overthrow or lie down with, and I fuss regard him in his fucking face. Off
as
his,
you do.
Off his. Mentioned who you are? I'm confused now. But I pushed Radar him right out of his throne. He was sat on his throne talking to me. I was like, Radar! And then killed all his guards and stuff. Anyway, like, a few hundred quid later, everybody forgot about it. Killing a chicken? No fucker let that lie.
Wow.
You don't let that lie.
Shit, that's actually really funny. So chickens are dangerous in game. Because in Zelda, you hit it so
the meme
times.
King, this is Johnny Floyd.
Johnny Floyd, king of memes.
He's there, he's latching!
Did I mention that earlier?
So I don't know, I possibly did though. I can't remember. There's a lot for me to keep up, but like, you know, I have to breathe. I have to think. Think and breathe.
Graham's also playing Ocarina of Time. He's liking it. I don't know if I'd like it if it were the first time I played it. I'm not sure. I'd like to wipe my brain and just try.
My mum loved it. She'd never played it before, and I got first 3DS.
I might just
played it.
But I know that fucking frog thing, but there's like a bit where you get to a king and you need a bottle or something.
That's the Zora Palace fucking thing, isn't it? Yeah,
Zora
Palace is shit. I did, and he did. You don't call us a wanker! Why are you calling me a wanker? I'll throw my cat at you.
I stole this one. If you can get that one. I stole this off Ariane because she didn't post it in the group for some reason.
Oh yes, I'll try and find that one.
But this kind of would make sense. Right, it's a Zelda thing.
It's
Link getting the Master Sword.
Ba, 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 ba.
From its usual place, that's it.
Bear with me. I've got several monitors to make sure.
Right.
There we go.
See, so in the new Zelda,
you've
got the fucking Hyrule Castle and it's surrounded by this fucking evil shit, which is Ganon.
Bowser does love you.
And so that sword, you imagine it in the forest normally.
Yeah.
But at the end of Wind Waker, when you kill Ganon, you stick it in his fucking head, it's pretty brutal.
Right, okay.
And then I can't remember, I think he sort of turns to stone or something.
Spoiler!
Right? I think he turns to stone. Now this is underwater, I think, but it's near the castle, right near the castle, which is underwater. Yeah. So you can imagine him being put underground, like just there, like that.
Centuries later, after
just
his old dried
yeah,
out.
Yeah, he's got that in his fucking head, they put him underground, left sword there, because that's what's killed him. That's that. Now all the seas come down, and there's sea salt. Like there's bits of like ore that you collect in the new Zelda, and like minerals and stuff. But there's like it says some like old sea fucking ores, something
right,
weird, which you find in the rocks.
Right.
So it's implying that it's after Wind Waker and the sea's gone down. So I can actually buy that.
Could happen.
Could be in the kids. I think that could happen.
That'd be sweet.
And there's theories that this might be a convergence of the timeline, bringing them all back together somehow.
Right.
And yeah. So yeah, I can buy that. I can believe that. I know it's just like a little meme.
Well,
sort
that
of thing.
New Zelda is the only Zelda I've actually really wanted to play.
Yeah, it looks cool as fuck. It looks
jet epic.
Okay, Chris Tolstoy posting a cool looking.
No, he didn't.
Sumer's pad, but he's a ballad.
That one.
He can't plumb. I didn't get it at first. I was like, what's this shit? But he's a friend of ours, by the way.
Yeah.
But he's got all the controllers in, basically.
Yeah, I'll have to make it bigger in order to show up.
Well, that's a little image, I suppose, yeah.
There you go.
Kind of cool.
Okay, now there, yeah. So we've got the N64.
Sure.
Master System, Mega Drive, sorry. N64.
Then we've got the SNES one, which is in a SNES and a mouse. Who's got that shitty Mega Drive one there?
Mega Drive one.
Yeah.
And GameCube, there's one. Wii.
Oh, there's a few duplicates, Dreamcast.
Yeah, there's lots of duplicates on GameCube. I'm actually going to put off now there's lots of duplicates because there's enough console joypads out there.
Yeah, I think they could have flagged it and done that.
See, so, yeah, that's what happens when Chris Tunsell does stuff because he.
I don't imagine that's a real thing though, is it? That's just a mock up.
Well, it's just collage, isn't it?
Right. Whoa. So Lewis Waddington.
Wiggle Waddington.
This is the Bioshock Collection announcement trailer. I mean, you might be able to play this, actually.
Okay. One sec.
And he can't wait. He says, wow, I cannot wait. Okay.
That is right there. I'm going to knock the audio off.
Little sound off. But I don't fancy playing them again. Really.
There we go. I
mean, that looks exactly the fucking same as I remember anyway.
Well, that's the trouble with the... Oh, right, Liam, 84. What's up, Nico?
What's up, buddy? Yeah. Long time no see.
Yeah.
Why didn't you win at Mario Kart? What's up, Liam? What are you doing? So, yeah, I don't know. I've played these, and I have no...
I never played number two, because I wasn't taken by number one.
Yeah, well, you won't like number two, though.
Well, exactly, yeah. And when I played of Infinite, I didn't like the gameplay.
No, Infinite was definitely the worst. But it was still good. It's got cool stuff in like
it's
that.
Got, and it's got,
I thought the story was really cool.
Yeah, the narrative's meant to be really good, but I just don't like the gameplay.
That's like
it,
a multiverse.
Which is the flip side of Halo 5.
Yeah. Yeah. I like the gameplay, but... Don't like the narrative anymore, anyway.
Anymore, yeah.
So he's excited about that. A few people, actually. But you get all the DLC bits and bobs.
Well, you know.
I have them. I won't mind playing them. But I don't want to play that again. I'm done. Yeah. Right. Scorn teaser trailer.
I...
Erwin Schulze's.
Fucking have a massive...
Penis.
Massive...
Bullseye.
My dick's so big, it's behind you, it follows you, what do you do? Little Big, go and check out Little Big. We're staggering now. I'll try and bob through this trailer for a little bit. I'll get a little bit further in. I love the look of this game, because this, I like body horror. By your shit. As our friend Johnny Floyd is rightly pointing out. I do like body horror. I love H.R. Geiger's artwork. I mean, look at that. That's just...
Yeah, it's cool. I mean, for me, I just thought the trailer went on a bit too long.
I like the landscapes. I used to just sit there. I had a lot of H.R. Geiger art books and stuff, and I just sit there and look at the landscape. So when it's showing all these panning shots here, I get why you're a little bit like, come on, just get on the
game. Oh, cool, get on.
But
for
me, I'm like, wow, man, this 3D rendered.
Looks smaller. Then I got interested then because I've seen something happen. I thought, hey, come on, do something. I want to see the game.
This is being released in two sections, two parts.
Right.
This game's being released in two parts. I can't remember what the first part's called. I think it might be called Denizen or something. It's a open area, not open world, open area, first person survival horror puzzle game.
Oh, cool. Sounds right on my street.
So, apparently, the directors of art directors and stuff, which basically just look like this. I mean, that image there is just fucking Geiger all over. Or Giger, depending which way you want to take it. But yeah, so what it is you're missing around and they've said that they tried to make a fully realised lived-in world.
Right.
So this here, is that what you're seeing right there, is apparently everything is working, is like creatures would have lived here, which is why
coming
across something like this, looking like it's in pain, an old shag.
I love this gun, it's so disgusting.
Grim.
Look at that.
Oh, it's flaccid. So, I can imagine this being the type of game where I would feel very, very uneasy for quite a while, and then this acceptance of this biomechanic
freezing a little. Yeah, I think we've got too much
going on. So, I'm looking forward to that one. I really am looking forward to
that. It does look sweet, and I do want to play it. Hopefully, it won't get cancelled. Is it a PC thing?
It's funded.
It's done.
Yeah, they've got stretch goals now. The stretch goals are sorry, because stream's freezing. I think Sub-Zero is watching.
That's funny. I just thought it was funny. I'm just reading Sub-Zero's watching because that's funny.
He is watching.
Yeah. So
all the Mortal Kombat people watch this.
Everybody, Scorpion,
and these guys as well.
All them. I mean,
they might look like they're looking in different directions, but...
It looks like Colossus is his back, actually.
Yeah, he's put his back out.
Yeah!
Got a bit rusty where his arse is. He's had a running poo and it's got a bit fucking... Yeah. Fucked you up.
Captain America's not too sure about that eagle. All right. Well, we took four altogether. Can it fuck off now?
He's scared of it, yeah.
He's a bit big, that.
Shoot.
Look, he's got his shield ready. He's like, I'll chin down. If it leans over at me, I'll fucking have that.
Or he's just trying to get into shit on Colossus.
Yeah, just have a crap on his head.
I gave you loads this morning.
Well, it looks like the guy behind below is pushing his arm up like, fuck off, Captain. No, I've got to put this eagle on your head. Fuck off. Anyway, I didn't think about it. I should have thought of a storyline.
Can I log in via mobile? What's up, buddy?
Sup? That's Mr. Chris.
I was struggling with mobile, mate. It always likes to fuck up on me.
So anyway, yeah, back onto Voice of the People. Yeah, scoring is actually funded. It's definitely coming out on Steam. It's going to be in two parts. It's going to be kind of an open world thing. They haven't given us any details on how long it would take, but every area is just like open. You can like wander
around. Oh, sweet! I want to be in there, fucking around.
But like I say, I think there's going to be this really odd, uneasy feeling for quite a while, and then you'll just get desensitized to the horrors.
Yeah, you'll feel like you live there,
right? And that's what I like about them kind of games. And that's what I liked about Lovecraft, Geiger, because you look at his artwork, you're like, oh, and then at one point you go, I'm desensitized to this. And that's when it gets worrying.
Right.
Because you're like, shit, I shouldn't be. This is...
Because it's weird.
This is wrong. Yeah, and that's why I like it. It's that kind of twist in your mentality. Like, hang on a minute, I shouldn't be accepting this as a norm.
What's if there's stuff coming out of the walls as well?
Yeah.
Like just in the walls and then...
Well, most of Geiger's stuff is extremely sexual. It's all about penetration and pregnancy.
A lot of vaginas in there.
Yeah, it's all penetration and pregnancy. And it's
not many titties.
Oh, there is.
Titties.
Yeah, there's a shit ton of titties, yeah. Titties. Anyway,
Ryan Clark, just wondering if there's a difference between 360 Minecraft and Xbox One Minecraft. Apparently, it's just a lot bigger.
Right.
A lot bigger. Too big is the problem.
Oh, right, okay.
It's just too big, so it's annoying. Yeah, it was. And a little bit shinier. Graham Daly, Tekken Tag 2 is £3.99 on PSN.
That's really good. Go and pick that up.
Go now.
Pick that up. That is a deal. That is a steal. Unless you don't like Tekken Tag. We've got Mr. Johnny Floyd right there. Can't wait for Injustice 2. I can't wait to watch all the cutscenes of Injustice 2.
We did that with first one. Yeah. We watched all the... Jailers, yeah. Didn't we? The cutscenes.
Yeah, and it was like a 3-hour movie, and it was really like interesting. Yeah. Like, oh, that was good.
Yeah.
Why don't they make that into a film? And then Batman vs Superman came out.
And then we wish they never bothered. And some of these scenes are supposed to be alright that they put in it.
It's 4 hours
it's
now.
Supposed
isn't
to
it?
Make a little bit more sense.
Is it 4 hours? Yeah, about 3 and a bit hours now. Yeah. I keep toying with the idea.
And there's blood and stuff in it now. It's a little bit gory.
Yeah, I'll watch it because I want to watch it. Because I like Zack Snyder as a director. A lot of people slag him off, but I really liked Watchmen, and I liked 300, and that's all good.
Get that up because that looks sweet. So, Spirit put this up.
It's me again.
And it didn't show much of E3, did it?
Sorry.
Was this on the Xbox conference? Is it exclusive to Xbox, actually?
No.
So it's the guys that made Limbo.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm struggling at the moment because bandwidth is dying.
But anyway.
Right, I'll find it now.
It's called, what's it called?
It's called Inside.
Inside. And it's like Limbo, it's a puzzle game. It looks fucking good, like Limbo. But it doesn't look amazingly good. But apparently it is fucking amazingly good.
It's out now.
When I watch it and I see the stuff going on in the background and stuff like that, I'm like, yeah, it looks really nice, this, that and the other. But everybody's so passionate about it in the reviews. Like, they're like, this is really good, you don't understand. There's something about it. So, and I love these types of games. So, I might have a do. This shit,
I mean, the trailer to show that E3 on Xbox didn't show anything. It showed more atmosphere than gameplay.
I got a feeling for it though, didn't I? I said it's a feeling for it, and it's a bit weird. But it's supposed to be pretty fucking good and a bit weird with the end and stuff. Like 3-hour game. Hmm. Don't know how much it is.
3-hour game.
Yeah.
That'll be free in the next two months.
Yeah, that's why I'm thinking about not getting it until they make it half price or free.
I think he's gonna go on Xbox first though, that's the thing. Alright, there's quite a bit of gameplay here, it does look pretty. It's a return to the Heart of Darkness type game and the Another World and Another World. It's all that kind of stuff, because that's essentially what Limbo was anyway. It was just a more kinetic pace, or phonetic, is it phonetic? Yeah, phonetic pace game than a Another World, because they're obviously about 20 times as long as Another World, because I could finish Another World in half an hour.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a return to that kind of game. It's a 2D platforming narrative game.
Puzzles.
Yeah, it's good. Good.
But it's supposed to be really good. I don't know why it's really good, but it is supposed to be really good. I mean, it looks good.
It does look good.
But it's supposed to be really good.
Really good.
That's what, yeah, so I know it looks the part.
That's all I've got here.
Now entering sound.
Lots of good games coming to PS4, not enough time to play them. XCOM 2, No Man's Sky.
Oh, forget No Man's Sky.
Yeah, forget No Man's Sky.
Forget that, it's going to be boring.
Yeah,
shit.
It's going to disappoint.
It certainly will. Darren Bab Bigger, so a picture of him, now entering Silent Hill. Yeah.
Bear with me a second while everything comes up.
He's now entering Silent Hill. And Paul, I can leave that up for a bit. Paul Ashton Pash, he's doing his deals again.
Pash, the master deals, the deal huntist.
Yeah, what does he call him? Hunter, bargain hunter, but you're
bargain hunter.
Hat.
Yeah, I want to give him a pith hat and the gun, and I want to do a series for Paul, but obviously it's time permitting, and you guys in the group need to help out, and guess what you're doing right here?
Let's go. So finally, Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin, is at a sensible price, $15.99. Going straight in his basket. Otherwise, DLC, I assume.
Scholar of the First Sin, Scholar of the First Sin is Dark Souls 2 and the DLC.
Oh, right, so it's full.
It's a full game and stuff like that.
Full pack.
I don't know, I like chill games sometimes. Chill games are good.
I do.
No Man's Sky, I get that, because we've talked about it many times. I'm ebb and flow with that one, don't I? But like, man, I really want to play it, and then,
it's because I know every world's the same, even though it's different. But it just isn't different, is it? You're fucking collecting shit.
Colour palette.
The same stuff in a different coloured world with a different fish. And then going to another world. And there's a space battle that doesn't look epic for some reason. It looks...
I bet they're interesting every now and again, but as long as they don't happen all the time. Because if they happen all the time, you'd get sick of it.
Yeah.
If they happen really, like, every now and again, I mean, talking fucking super rare, where you're warping, you're in the middle of a battle, then you'd be like, wow, right, okay, I'm invested now. But then again, you wouldn't get enough experience in space combat in order to
be good at it. Yeah.
Stick to Elite Dangerous. Mind you, it's not out on PlayStation 4, so fuck you. Yeah, Elite Dangerous is good.
And another bargain. Fire Emblem Fates Conquest for less than £20. So if he says that's cheap, then trust me.
Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah, because I didn't make a remark about this thumbnail image right here. Is not what it says there. I was happy to see that a big website is having the same issues that I have every now and again.
Yeah, it's just cool with Lego, isn't it? That's supposed to be alright at all, you know.
The Lego Star Wars. I don't want to play it because it's just one Star Wars movie.
Extra stuff in it that outside from different areas.
Only a battle if you're in a space knob.
Only a battle if you're a space knob.
Is that meant to be noob, or are you calling me a knob?
He is a knob and a noob. LA Hotel, Johnny Floyd, speaking of the devil. LA Hotel can't tell the difference between GTA 5 screenshot and actual LA. I think they put it on their
the hotel website. Yeah. Sorry, who else did that? Was it a Russian website that used pictures from...
They do it, they tweet stuff.
Command and Conquer.
Tanks. That are in wars that aren't, they're from fucking Call of Duty or Command and Conquer and stuff. Some have done it on purpose and they wrote that this is from this game, but even so, just don't tweet something from a game, it makes no sense.
Stupid.
I mean, we know you all just get it from Google like we do, but fucking hell.
I don't get it from Google, these are all actual images. Every image I see here I've edited just enough in order to make them legally mine.
Gavin Edgerton, it was just a video of. Someone with one of them VR things, you know, we can see his hands and you can grab stuff in the game. Mm. You can move every finger on both hands. She was playing that.
Using your hands.
Steven Tunstall, Sonic Boom, which is a guy dressed like Guile throwing two copies of Sonic Boom.
Yeah.
Boom fashion.
I watched that. Yeah.
With no sound for some reason.
No, shit.
That's that.
Erin Hughes there, showing.
Last week's
Ramble On.
In time.
Yeah, look at that. And somebody called Johnny Floyd did this little image. Yeah, I don't know who Johnny Floyd is.
He's the image master.
He sounds like a wrong'un. He sounds like a wrong'un.
Master of memes and master of images.
So that is the voice of the people.
That is the voice of the people.
We're like the fucking Jeremy Corbyn of gaming.
That is done. We cannot be moved. Can't get rid of us. No matter how much you want us to go, you just can't get rid of us.
I like the party I've got going on.
Oh wow! I like her dance. Can't do it. Boy. Oh, Ken, what are you doing, man? Leaving B. Who's this sexy bitch wiggling her ass?
She's from King of Fighters.
Wow.
I've got one.
And he's proper staring at her ass. What's it called? Tomahawk
or something like that.
Little Link just chilling.
Yeah, I mixed it up.
I really like that. I really do.
Chill.
This one's dance now.
Thank you very much for watching, you set of motherfuckers.
Yeah.
I fucking hate you bastards. In a nice way. In a nice way.
That's still buzzing off them.
Cool, ain't it?
Yeah, fucking.
Yeah. I did that before you
told me. I want to go to that party.
Yeah, that'd be a top party. That'd be a really good party, wouldn't it?
Put your stereotypes.
That'd be after that Sakura bird and
she's cute. I would go for cute. She's sexy, so she'll know her power.
I really dislike you too, Ariane. I dislike you more than I dislike other things, which means that you're the best at disliking. Yeah, so thank you very much for joining us tonight. Thanks for Johnny Floyd for giving us the images that we put on the front. And
I'm chatting, dude.
If anybody on the group wants to do any kind of images with Show Me Games in and stuff, we'll put that at the beginning and I'll drop it in at this point.
Even if it doesn't have Show Me Games, we'll put it on anyway. We'll just slap that on.
I'll just
touch
Show Me Games on.
We'll just slap it on.
Over the really important bit that you've spent ages photoshopping. I put loads of shadows on this and I'll go, Show Me Games!
Yeah, you don't need to trouble yourself.
Yeah, don't worry about that and we'll credit you for it. Thanks for everybody who turned up to the Retro Games Night at the Batcave.
Yes.
Brian, bless his voice. Better late than never! I'm Brian Blessed! I can't do it. It's hard work to maintain that height.
I'm angry! Imagine talking like that all the time.
I want to it! He's done fucking Everest. He's tried Everest.
I know.
Like, more than anybody's ever tried Everest. One of the favourite stories I ever heard of him is like, I went to see the Dalai Lama, and I used to box when I was in the army. I used to box when I was in the army.
And his balls dropped.
I bet
his balls, really high pitched like Michael Jackson.
I reckon his balls dropped about 3 weeks after he was born.
Yeah.
I bet he was crying like this.
Maybe it was before he was born.
Yeah, his balls
appeared first.
Yeah, that's what brought the waters.
Yeah.
He gave birth to his balls. You're giving birth to some... Oh no, he used his head.
Oh shit.
Sean Connery. We've
got someone else again.
Yeah. So we wronged it. Yeah, so thanks for everybody there. Sean Connery. Did you see that post I put on Facebook? It was a picture of...
Yeah, I did.
Three shingles need to be nailed. He's like, three shingles, you shit. Yeah,
that's how you do the accent.
Sean Connery.
Anyone can do the accent, just reading that
Sean
sign.
Connery. Remember, 4,000 no's and a yash means yash. Yes, the rippiest bomb. Yeah, so, yeah, again.
Yeah, there's a Halo review coming up as well.
Halo 5. We did Halo 5 stream on Friday. 5 hours, 15 minutes. It took us to finish that game.
On easy,
we will say it's on easy. And it's shit. That game is shit.
It's average.
Yeah.
As far as Halo goes.
As far as Halo games go, it is the worst Halo game.
But you'll be able to read his review.
Yeah,
on that.
We'll do a review on that. I think I might also try and get around to do, if I get enough time, to do an article about why I think paying for a game affects your review score, which should double on why a 5 out of 10, which is going to be my score, but you'll have to read the review, 5 out of 10 for a free game should really fucking put you off that game.
Well, I've had loads of free games and I put them on, I'll switch them off straight away. Yeah. I'm like, this is fucking shit, I don't care. I just don't like it personally.
Yeah, well, this is it. If I spend 50 quid on Halo 5, Sean,
I actually think prices can make a difference, but it's kind of irrelevant because you kind of know that Halo should be a good game.
Yeah.
Regardless of how much. Even if I got it for a fiver, I'd be thinking, wow, that's a really good deal because it should be like 50 quid and maybe it's come down. But it should still be, I'm expecting it to be a fucking good game.
With the fact that ODST, which is considered to be the worst in the first person series of Halo.
Yeah.
Is considerably
better than that. It's not because they had that glitch that fucked
up. Yeah, that would have really ruined everything. So, thanks a lot. If you would share, like, subscribe on YouTube and all that kind of shit. And thanks for being a member of the group and thanks for being part of the chat. That, it helps.
Yeah.
It helps this, helps banter and
stuff. Can have a chat and shit,
innit? Anyway, so, anyway.
Talking.
I've got a crack pipe going cold, so.
Oh, fuck. Don't say that.
I've got to go.
There's only so much.
I'll see you later.
Bye. Hey little dude, did you have your moment to shine? Someone posted a cat sucking a dog off today.
See you later!
That was weird. Got out scratching his balls and